Hello, my name is Sasha McIntosh Hobson. I'm an agronomist and field crop consultant working at UniAg Cooperative. I work in the Haut-Saint-Laurent region of Montérégie West here in Quebec. I wanted to make a short series of videos this year to highlight a few critical phases in corn. So whether it be grain corn or silage corn, as these are major productions here in our region of Quebec. I wanted to not only highlight the importance of a few of these critical phases and why they're worth paying attention to each season, but I also wanted to give a broad perspective on the conditions the crop is being exposed to or subjected to this season, and the impact that that might have on these critical phases, and thus the impact it can have on the overall production at the end of the year. So, without further ado, let's go into the fields and take a look at the first critical phase that I wanted to highlight in this video. We are in the beautiful city of Les Cèdres, just north of my hometown of Valleyfield. It's June 15th. It's warm, it's humid, it's clouded over. You can see the dark clouds around me. This has been a theme this year where we've had a lot of rain. It's been quite cool, even though today is quite warm and humid. At first, I wanted to look at this stage. Now, this corn here is about at the height of my knees. It's at the V6 stage, so it's actually at the tail end of the critical period I wanted to look at in this first video. The period is from V3 to V6. Now, this is an important period. The corn is transitioning from reliance on the seed and its carbohydrates and the seminal roots associated with that seed that takes up a little bit of water and nutrients for that early plant life. And it's transitioning to its nodal root system. And the nodal roots are the primary root system for your corn. So from V6 on, all its water, all its nutrients are going to be derived from these roots. So its establishment is particularly critical. It's an important moment to observe certain factors that might impact that establishment or might impact its development. And this ranges from biotic stresses, whether that be insect damage, fungal pathogen damage, often these two are intertwined. It can be abiotic stresses, whether that be herbicide damage, whether that be conditions that are too dry, conditions that are too wet, compaction. These are all factors that play into how well the corn plant transitions from moving away from the reliance of that seed, which begins at a roughly V3, to really fully establishing early on those nodal roots, which in ideal conditions happens at around V6. So let's take a moment now to look at what that stage looks like. We'll dig up a plant and observe its roots and see what the tail end of that transitional period looks like. So come, let's go take a look. So before we jump into the anatomy of this root system, this here is a Mazex cornfield. It's one of Mazex's brand new hybrids, the MZ3930. This is a 2950 CHU corn, which is really ideally placed to be competitive in our 3000 CHU zone here in southwestern Quebec. So let's take a look at the root system now. First and foremost, we can assess the vegetative stage here. Now, this is unlike counting leaves, we're counting visible collars. So here we have the first leaf, evident by its small round shape. And so that's collar one, two, three, four, five, and six. And this seventh collar, we can't see yet. It's coming, but we're not there yet. So this is the V6 stage. And of course, there's more leaves than the vegetative stage. We count one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight leaves that have curled over. So a different way of assessing the stand. Now, if we take a look at the root system here, now we can see the vestiges
of that seminal root system here. See, here we have the seed, the radical, its root hairs, and some lateral seminal roots that derive from that seed. And as we can see, well, it's, I don't know if you can see it well in this video, but this seed is near but used up completely here. It's like a little empty sack here. So it did its job. It got this plant to V3 and helped it transition while these nodal roots developed. And this is culminated with the very last nodal roots, which are really from the sixth and sometimes seventh node, which we see on the outside of the soil, which we refer to as brace roots. And these brace roots help to keep the plant grounded, but they are exactly like every other nodal root really before it, where its main job is to draw nutrients and water for the developing corn. When analyzing this plant, we can see really a very healthy root system. You know, a developed seminal root system and a well-developed nodal root system. So the transition that this plant went through not only successfully, but with likely very little stress, or not enough stress to really impact the transition period and the establishment of these critical nodal roots.
What we've lived through so far in this 2022 agricultural season, specifically during this critical phase, V3 to V6, and how it's impacted it. And for the most part, it's been really positive. We've had an abundance of water. We've had sunny days. Sure, it's not been the warmest spring, that granted. However, there haven't been weather extremes. You know, we haven't had it be too cold. It's been a little on the colder side this year, but it hasn't been too cold, nor has it been too hot. And plants that have ideal kind of milky conditions, as it were, weather-wise, with an abundance of water, generally are not stressed. And there hasn't been too much insect damage, nor fungal damage, nor adverse events such as hail in the region that I work in. And of course, this differs in various regions and various spots within my own region, where some have had too much water. And, you know, some have had really too much cold weather, where it has maybe had an impact on this period. But for the most part, this year, it's been quite positive. And one of the things you can look at in your field is, especially this year, where when we planted, and we had quite a beautiful planting window this year, followed by rain and decent conditions, where everything came up uniformly in the field. And emergence was uniform for the most part, just as we want and need in a cornfield. Now, that uniformity can change if there's an impact on this critical phase. So if there is a delay in the establishment of those nodal roots, if there is an over-reliance because of a delay on that seed and its carbohydrates, you're going to see a little bit of stunting. So on the plant level, you can see a plant that, if it's subjected to adverse conditions in that period, could become stunted. You know, could have a major impact for that plant on its production by the end of the year. So that's looking at the plant level. Now looking at the field level, that can play into the uniformity of the field. Whereas some spots that might have great conditions will continue to flourish, like this field, and others, you know, that may be subjected to adverse events in this critical period. So you might see the changing of the guard, as it were, at the start of the season, where you have a uniform field, to more variability as it transitions through this period. So this has an impact on this crop in particular. As we know, uniformity is one of the big names of the game here. But thus far this season, so far so good. So let's see how the rest of the season progresses and evolves. And catch me when I take a look at our second critical phase that I want to look at. And we'll see in this 2022 season how we've progressed to that and how the conditions will affect that next phase. See you then.